In this video, we'll talk about EOQ model, that is economic order quantity model with quantity discounts. Till now, we have developed models by taking unit cost C to be known and constant during the cycle time. However, in practice, the retailer offers discount in purchase price to increase his sales. And that is what we observed during January 26 celebration, Diwali celebration, Christmas celebration. That is almost every time we have something in terms of discount during festival seasons and consequently profit. There are two types of quantity discounts. One is all unit discounts and second one incremental quantity discounts. In this video, we will talk about incremental quantity discounts. By incremental quantity discount, I mean if I buy 10 items, it will be available at rupees 100. If I buy items more than 10 and less than 20, then the purchase price is say 9 rupees. And if I buy items more than 30 in number, then those items will be available at rupees 8. So this is what is called incremental quantity discounts. The model which we will be developing here is based on following assumptions. The system deals with single item. The demand rate of R units per time unit is known and constant. Shortages are not allowed. Lead time is zero. Replenishment rate is infinite. Replenishment size, that is Q, is decision variable. The inventory holding cost H per unit per time unit is known and constant. Ordering cost A per order is known and constant during the period under review. These are also the basic assumptions of classical economic order quantity model. Since the purchase price of an inventory item is variable, it is to be included while finding the total cost of an inventory system. Suppose there are several price breaks, say 0, B1, B2 up to Bn, and order quantity Q lies in the price breaks BK-1 to BK. And the corresponding unit cost for Q units is CK, where CK is less than CK-1. Then, the total annual cost in the discounted period is TCK equal to CKR, that is purchase cost, plus AR by Q, that is ordering cost, plus CK IQ by 2, that is holding cost, and Q lies between BK-1 and BK. So here is a graph which says that B1, B2, B3 are price breaks. That is, it shows that for each unit price, there is a different range. We also have solid curve and dotted curve, or we can say broken curve. The broken curve indicates an infeasible solution. We need to move in each price break to find the optimal lot size which minimizes the total inventory cost. Let us discuss EOQ model with one price break. Suppose the retailer offers quantity discount at B1. So price break looks like Q1 lies between 0 and B1 and Q1 units are available at C1 price per unit. And if Q2 is greater than B1, then Q2 units are available at price C2 and it is less than C1. We will use following algorithm to determine optimal purchase quantity. First step is consider the lowest price C2 and compute Q2 using the basic EOQ formula. If B1 is less than or equal to Q2, then Q2 is the required lot size to be purchased and compute optimal cost associated with Q2. Step 2. If Q2 is less than B1, then compute Q1 with price C1 and corresponding total cost DCQ1. Compare total cost by procuring Q1 units with total cost of procuring B1 units, that is compare TCB1 and TCQ1. If TCB1 is greater than TCQ1, then buy Q1 units, otherwise purchase B1 units. Now using this algorithm, let us have one example. An automobile manufacturer purchases 2,400 castings over a period of 1 year. This requirement is fixed and known. These castings are subject to quantitative discounts. Ordering cost is ₹70,000 per order and carrying charge fraction is 12% of the unit cost. Determine the optimal purchase quantity if the supplier has offered the following unit price for the castings. If castings are purchased between 0 to 1000, it will cost ₹1000 per unit. And if it is more than 1000, then price will be ₹950 per unit. So we have ordering cost to be ₹70,000 per order. Demand, that is R, is 2400 units per month. I is ₹0.12 per unit per annum. C1 is ₹1000 per unit and C2 is ₹950 per unit. Clearly, C2 is less than C1. Step 1. Algorithm says you start with the lowest purchase price. So we start with lowest purchase price C2 and compute Q2 using EOQ formula, that is square root 2AR upon C2 into I. Plugging all values of A, R, C2 and I in the formula gives me 1716 units. And because it is casting, we are approximating it to integer quantity. This is greater than 1000. That is Q2 is greater than B1. So Q2 is within the range of Q2 greater than 1000. Therefore, the optimum purchase quantity is Q2 is equal to 1716 units, which will minimize the total cost of the inventory system. Let us have one more example. The annual demand of a product is 10,000 units. Each unit costs ₹100 if the orders are placed in quantities below 200 units. For order of 200 or above, the unit price will be ₹95. The annual inventory holding cost is ₹10% of the value of the item and the ordering cost is ₹5 per order. Find the economic lot size. So we are given R is equal to 10,000 units per year. Ordering cost A is ₹5 per order. Inventory carrying charge fraction I is 10% of the price of an item. We need to have price breaks first. So it is given in a second line that each unit costs ₹100 if order place is less than 200 units. So we have first price break as Q1 lies between 0 to 200, then purchase price is ₹100. If it is more than 200, Then units are available at rupees 95 per unit. So what I can say, C2 is rupees 95 per unit and C1 is rupees 100 per unit. So C2 is discounted price. Consider the lowest purchase price C2 and find Q2 using economic order quantity formula. Substituting values of ordering cost, demand rate, purchase price and carrying charge fraction, we get Q2 is equal to 103 units. That is less than 200, which was the price break. So we have Q2 less than B1. Then algorithm says I need to go to step 2. Step 2, determine Q1 with purchase cost C1. Here in classical EOQ formula, I will have to take purchase price as C1, which is 100 rupees. So I'm getting Q1 is equal to 100 units, which is less than 200, which was the price break, B1. So Q1 is less than B1. So we need to compare total cost by procuring B1 units and total cost by procuring Q1 units. Total cost by procuring Q1 units is 10,01,000 rupees. And that of B1 units is 9,51,200 rupees. TC Q1 is greater than TC B1. Therefore, the optimum purchase quantity is B1 is equal to 200 units. Now let us have a EOQ model with two price breaks. Here, the price discounts offer is as follows. If you order or purchase Q1 units which falls between 0 and B1, then they are available at rupees C1. If Q2 lies between B1 and B2, then purchase price is C2. And if it is more than B2, then those units will be available at C3 price per unit. With C1 greater than C2 greater than C3. So we have incremental discounts. That means if I buy Q1 units, those are available at C1 rupees. If I buy Q2 units, they will be available at C2 rupees. And if I buy Q3 units, they will be available at discounted price C3. Let us first have algorithm to determine the optimal lot size. As usual, like in the first one price break, we will start lowest price C3. Compute Q3 using EOQ formula. If Q3 is greater than or equal to B2, then Q3, TC Q3 is the optimal solution. If Q3 is less than B2, then go to step 2. Step 2, determine Q2 with purchase cost C2. If Q2 lies between B1 and B2, then compare TC Q2 and TC B2. If TC Q2 is greater than or equal to TC B2, then B2 TC B2 is the optimal solution. Otherwise, Q2 and total cost corresponding to Q2 units is optimal solution. If Q2 is less than B1 as well as B2, then go to step 3. Find Q1 with unit cost C1. Compare total cost of procuring B1 units, B2 units and Q1 units to find optimum economic order quantity. That the quantity with the lowest cost will be the optimal purchase quantity. We'll see this in example. Find the optimal order quantity for a product with following price breaks. If Order quantity is between 0 and 50, they are available at 10 rupees. If order quantity is between 50 and 100, they are available at 9 rupees. And if order quantity is more than 100 units, then they are available at 8 rupees. The monthly demand for the product is 200 units. The carrying charge fraction is 25% of the unit cost. And the replenishment cost is rupees 20 per order. So we have R is equal to 200 units per month. I is equal to rupees 0.25 per unit per annum. And A is equal to rupees 20 per order. So Q3 is 63 units. Q3 is less than B2. So we compute Q2 with C2 as a purchase cost. That gives me 60 units. So Q2 lies between B1 and B2. To decide optimum purchase quantity, we compare TCQ2, which is 1934 rupees plus 0.16 paisa. TCB2 is rupees 1740. So clearly TCQ2 is greater than TCB2. So we procure 100 units, which is B2, and that will optimize my total cost. Next example, a manufacturing firm requires 2000 units of material per year. The ordering cost is rupees 10 per order, while the carrying cost is rupees 0.16 per year per unit of the average inventory. The purchase price is rupees 1 per unit. Also, a discount of 5% is available for order of 1000 units. For order above 2000 units, cost will be 0.93 per unit. Question is, what should be the purchase quantity? So we are given R is equal to 2000 units per year, A is equal to rupees 10 per order, and I is equal to rupees 0.16 per unit per year. And quantity discounts we need to formulate. It said that if you purchase less than 1000 units, it is available at rupees 1. If it is between 1000 and 2000, purchase price is 95 paisa. And if it is more than 2000 units, purchase price is 93 paisa. So we start with lowest price, that is C3. Compute Q3, that turns out to be 519 units. Here Q3 is less than B2. So we need to compute Q2. Q2 with purchase cost C2, that is 95 paisa, turns out to be 512 units. Again, Q2 is less than B1, so we compute Q1. And Q1 with purchase price 1 rupees gives me 500 units. We have Q1 less than B1, so we need to compute cost and then we'll compare it. So total cost of purchasing 500 units turns out to be rupees 2040. Total cost of purchasing B1 units turns out to be rupees 1996. And total cost of purchasing B2 units is rupees 2018.80 paisa. So we have TCB1 less than TCB2 less than TCQ1. So optimum purchase quantity should be 1000 units, which was first price break as B1. A shopkeeper estimates the annual requirement of an item as 2000 units. He buys it from his supplier at a cost of rupees 10 per item, and the cost of ordering is rupees 50 each time he orders. If The stocking costs are 25% per year of stock value. How frequently should he replenish his stocks? Further, suppose the supplier offers a 10% discount on orders between 400 and 699 units, 20% discount on orders exceeding or equal to 700. Can the shopkeeper reduce his costs by taking advantage of either of the discounts? So first is, as usual, EOQ model. We are given R is equal to 2000 units per year. A is equal to rupees 50 per order. Purchase cost is rupees 10 per item. And inventory carrying charge fraction is 0.25 rupees. And H is equal to C into I. So 10 into 0.25, which is rupees 2.50. So Q, by plugging all this value, turns out to be 283 units, and total cost of purchasing 283 units is rupees 20,707.10. Now second part of the question says that if you procure units with less than 399, then it will cost 10 rupees. If procurement is between 400 and 699, it will cost 9 rupees. And more than 700 will cost 8 rupees. So we start with the lowest cost, that is rupees 8. Q3 with rupees 8 as a purchase cost gives me 316 units. But Q3 is less than B2, so I need to compute Q2. Q2 with purchase cost 9 rupees is 298 units. Here again Q2 is less than B1, so we compute Q1. Q1 turns out to be 283 units, and that lies in the range. So we need to compare costs. Total cost of 283 units is 20,707.10. Total cost of B1 units is rupees 18,700. And total cost of B2 units is rupees 16,842.85. So B2 is equal to 700, which is corresponding to lowest cost. So we will order for 700 units. Hence, the shopkeeper should accept the order of 20% discount, because in this case, his net saving per year would be rupees 20,707.10 minus 16,842.85. So that results into saving of rupees 3,864.25. So we had seen different incremental quantity discounts, and this algorithm can be extended for N price breaks. Thank you.